And good afternoon, everyone. Welcome to the Midday. I'm Art Rascone. A happy Monday to you. I hope you survived the weekend well enough. We're in for a great week ahead. And here is the latest now on COVID-19 as we continue to follow, of course, this incredible story throughout the world. The gradual reopening of Texas, that begins today. It's now okay to visit state parks. ABC 13 reporter Jeff Ealing at Sheldon Lake Park in Northeast Harris County with much more on the first phase of this reopening.
There's not a flood of visitors here today, but the regulars who enjoy the trails are back. They say it's good to see the state slowly starting to return to normal.
Them closing the park was almost as devastating for me as it was for the kids learning they wouldn't be able to go back to school with their friends.
Monica Adams was a regular at Sheldon Lake State Park before coronavirus concerns closed it, but she was back just after 8 o'clock this morning on the first day Texans could return to state parks.
I felt like it was a way to feel like we're on the track to being back to normal, to being able to just see that things are going in the right direction.
Adams has been helping her young kids navigate online classes and has not had a chance to get outside very much in the last few weeks. Today that changed, and she doesn't mind wearing a mask as long as it gets her back to nature.
I would much rather have to wear the mask and be able to come than not come at all.
Let's go, guys.
Arnold Camino and his daughter were among the first to return to the trails around Sheldon Lake.
Staring at the walls is not good at the house, you know. And you go out here and you get some good exercise.
Camino was also a daily park visitor before the shutdown. He's ready for the entire state to reopen, but right now he's happy to enjoy these first steps.
It means a lot. I've been sitting around for, well, I think this park's been closed about 2.5, 3 weeks.
So far of day one with the parks reopening here in the state of Texas, it's been slow but steady. At Lake Sheldon, Jeff Eagle, ABC 13 Eyewitness News.
Good to see some people out. Well, we're waiting to see if Congress can come up with a deal to add more money to that Paycheck Protection Program. That's the program that provides loans to small businesses to keep them alive and allow their employees to still get paid. It ran out of its initial $350 billion allocation. Lawmakers are now hoping to add at least $300 billion more to that program. Another round of stimulus payments are on the way, this time in a form of checks in the mail instead of those direct deposits. Look at the memo there down on the lower left. As reported, the checks will have President Trump's name on them, a huge controversy. This is a first in U.S. history. Well, the popular El Bolillo bakery gave out free pan dulce in Spanish this morning as a way to thank its customers in these challenging times. Great story here. Courtney Fisher shows us hundreds lined up to get the free bread.
The line wrapped around the block.
Thank you, sir. Thank you.
Free bags of bolillos will do that.
Giving away 10 per car.
El Bolillo Bakery has been closed for 3 weeks, right after all of this started.
It also gave us a chance to figure out a plan in order to be able to come back for our community.
They knew they had to come back because the regulars depend on them.
We appreciate y'all and love y'all.
The thing is, some of those loyal customers are having a tough time right now. Free bread was the easiest way to help.
And it is our way of saying thank you to our community and our way of helping them out.
A steady stream of cars and trucks moved through the parking lot. For 90 minutes, workers wheeled metal rack after rack out of the bakery. 500 white bags of bolillos, 500 families left with hot homemade bread.
Thank you.
Left grateful and thankful and laughing.
There are a lot of dark times that we see, and it is hard. So to be able to see even somebody smile and know that we're a part of that, it makes the job 100% worth it.
And the bakery will do it all again Wednesday and on Friday.
Stay strong. If there is any way that we can help you, we will.
What a great gesture by that bakery company. Courtney Fisher reporting. And that's it for the Midday. Thanks for joining us. Have a terrific day. Enjoy your week. Better days are ahead. In fact, on Friday, the state is opening all retail shops, but only on a to-go basis. They will not be allowed in. You will not be allowed into the store. But eventually that will happen, and as well restaurants and everything else. We will enjoy them once again. Thanks for joining us. Have a terrific day. We'll see you back here tomorrow for the Midday.